having a very good day. This is Siva Jagadish Kumar, Assistant Professor, Vignan University, Department of Textile Technology. In this session, we are going to discuss about the garment dyeing machines. What are the various different types of garment dyeing machines which are available, their advantages, disadvantages, and which are suitable for what type of garments. These are the things we are going to discuss in this session. So this is under the part of garment dyeing, printing and embroidery subject, regulation 16 TF 303. So the garment dyeing machines are very much different than the conventional type. That those are like a fabric dyeing machines. Okay. Whereas in fabric dyeing machines, it is a continuous form, means there are various types are there, like jigger, high temperature, high pressure, and various other machines. But in comparison with them, these are entirely different. Basically, these are two types. One is paddle machines, another one is rotary drum type machines. Okay, we are going to see in detail about these two. So, basic comparison between these two are like, the paddle machines consist of a very high liquor ratios, and then which is less economical and may limit shared reproducibility. So, some of the contents like socks knitting, okay, or maybe a handkerchief knitting, or sometimes even caps. So, some of these things are night pants or women's leggings. Okay. In those cases, what happens, specific shades which will be there, these will be keep on repeating. In those cases, the paddle machines are much more recommended. But whereas in rotary drum machines, so in this, what happens, a big drum will be there and it will be keep on rotating. It might have whether 4 compartments or 6 compartments or 8 compartments, in those cases it can be rotated. In each compartment, different type of garments can be loaded, but the dye particle or the kind of dye which is going to be used is common. Okay. That is about the rotary drum. So, the rotary drum machines are preferred, such as which are require very gentle handling, like woolen sweaters, or some of the knitted garments also. In those cases, the rotary drum type machines are much recommended than the paddle machines. Paddle machines are the one where the shade is constant, or maybe if it is a very small garment as like a sock and all, in those cases, the paddle machines are much more recommended. But in case of rotary drums, wherever the gentle care is required, in those cases, this machines, the rotary drum machines, are much more recommended. Whereas if you consider which can go for high temperatures, sometimes some of the dye particles require higher temperature, more than 100 degrees centigrade. Generally, paddle machines are not recommended to go for more than 100 degrees centigrade. And whereas the rotary drum machines can be equipped with even high temperature also. Of course, in paddle also certain versions are there which can go with higher temperature, but in general recommendation, paddle machines are recommended or which are more like open bar system, and rotary drum which we can go for even high temperature and high pressure, or automation, automatic loading of chemicals, all these things. It means the possibility of automation is more in case of rotary drum machine than the paddle machine. So if you see, basically, the paddle machines and rotary drum machines. So, out of these two, if you further compare, the paddle machines consisting of three types. One is horizontal paddle, second one is lateral or oval type of paddle, and the third one is high temperature paddle machines. Whereas the rotary drum, one is like a rotary drum machine, another one is like a tumble dryer machine. One is rotary drum machine, another one is a tumble dryer machine. Tumble dyeing machine. So which is similar to the tumble dryer, okay, whereas a big box will be there and then in between we will be keep on. We will see that these different types of machines. So basically two categories of dyeing machines. One category is paddle dyeing machine, another category is rotary drum type dyeing machine. Paddle, what do you mean by paddling? You know, as like a paddle is an instrument which will be used for boat, right? Okay, so the paddling. So similarly, in the same case, a instrument, what it will do? It will be keep on push the dielectric. Okay, we will see in detail. And there is another, there are various other techniques are also there. All of them are not mentioned, like toroid dyeing machine. Okay, but nowadays it is obsolete, but in the terms of 1980s to 2010 and some sort of developments were there. We will see what is toroid also. And other developments are also there, but those are not much popular. Okay, so this is a paddle dyeing machine. So this paddle dyeing machine, what happens in this, the process of dyeing textiles in a machine that gently move the goods using paddles, similar to a paddle wheel on a boat. Okay, as like in the boat on the back side, how the paddle will be there, similarly this paddle wheel will be there. So this is slow process, but there is extremely little abrasion of the goods. Okay, extremely little abrasion of the goods, but still we have discussed that we cannot use sweaters under. Why? Because sweaters are very large garments. Okay, in these garments, what happens if you are using this paddling under, lot of entanglement will be created and the sleeves and other things may get stuck in terms of the paddle dyeing machine. That is the reason those kind of, some of the garments are not suitable for paddle dyeing machine. Okay, in this, a horizontal paddle machine. So horizontal paddle means a big drain will be there, very big bowl kind of, as like a boat or something. It will be consisting the dielectric up to some extent. On top of this, in this open bar, the garments are loaded and then there will be a paddle wheel at a certain extent. So this wheel will be rotating at a very slow speed. It varies between 1 to 40 RPM depending upon the situation and all. So once the entire process is done and all, maybe it can be a continuous system where dye particles and other chemicals can be added simultaneously onto this. That is one possibility. Or else we drain the entire shade or the dye and then we put another new dye also. Okay, that is how it can be done. So the paddle machine consists of the paddle wheel which will be keep on rotating between 1 to 40 RPM. And this will be consisting the entire dielectric on the machine where the garments will be loaded and the paddling will be done at a slow speed. Okay, so and it will be consisting of a dryness system. Okay, so the goods will be very slowly moving by means of this paddling action, and this paddle will never be immersed completely. Okay, say if the paddle wheel is 40 inches diameter, then only 16 inches will be the inside the depth of the dielectric. Okay, we need to make sure that it will be less than 40% itself. Okay, otherwise what happens, the driving mechanism and all also will be in the situation where it will be immersed and it is not a recommended thing. Okay, so the temperatures in this system can also be raised up to 98 degrees centigrade in these systems. Okay, 98 degrees centigrade. So this is another machine. This is a Vowel paddle machine. A Vowel paddle machine, instead of either a rectangle or circle and all, it will be consisting a Vowel shape. Okay, on one side of the Vowel there will be a paddle box. Okay, it will be keep on pushing the dye material such that it will send it, the entire dye material will be keep on circulating as like in the pond. Okay. So this also can be having up to 98 degree centigrade. Like, if you see, in between is like an island and the paddle wheel is at one side. So where So this is a oval paddle machine, whereas the shape is in the shape of the oval, the paddle is located at one side, it will be keep on pushing the material such that the circulation would take place. Okay. In this also up to 98 degrees centigrade can be kept. You see the in between the island is the empty space and the space is located as like an oval shape. Okay. In this oval, the complete dye particles will be there and the garments will be kept. As the paddle will be keep on rotating, what happens? The circulation of liquor and their garments will take place. The other one is HT paddle machine, that is high temperature paddle machines, whereas it can raise up to 140 degrees centigrade. Okay, so some of the polyester articles, polyester shirts and all can be dyed at these temperatures by using some additional chemicals. The general parameters in terms of the paddle machines are, it attracts high MLR ratios, 30:1 to 40:1. Okay, that is quite high while comparing the very modern advanced machines with the 8 MLR or 10 MLR or 12 MLR, that is the normal range of today's fabric dyeing machines. If you reduce this MLR, what happens is the amount of liquor will be so low that by means of this paddling, the material will not get moved. Okay. And in order to have the gentleness, the paddle edges, instead of as like a rectangle or something, it will be a curved edges of the paddle machines, means paddle edges. Okay. And the rotating speed, as we discussed, it is in between 1.5 RPM to 40 RPM, which is quite lesser than a fan speed or anything. Okay. 1.5 RPM to 40 RPM. What is RPM? Revolutions per minute. Then the circulation of liquor should be enough to prevent the goods from sinking it. Otherwise, if there is no movement, what happens? All the goods will be settled at the bottom. Then only the liquor will be moved at the top and the material will be at the ground. Okay, so that should be avoided. And these are suitable for even all the form of makeups like shirts, trousers, t-shirts, caps, socks, everything. Okay. Including polypropylene and polyethylene, means polypropylene bags and other things also can be used. So one is that the mesh kind of bags, okay, generally which we will carry for lemons or something to provide the air and all. So the garment will be loosely folded and kept inside this mesh bag, and this bag will be thrown into this machine. In case if it is a bigger garment, as like the trouser legs may get entangled. In order to avoid this sort of entanglement, what happens? It will be used with a PPE bags. It is a mesh kind of bag. So that what will happen? By using this mesh bag, the material will be properly set such that the entanglement can be avoided. And it should not be too much packed. Otherwise, what happens? The dyeing liquor may not get penetrated inside us. So that should be avoided. That is one of the very important criteria we need to see in terms of dyeing. So due to the entanglement, sometimes in case of trouser, means near the groin area or near the crotch point, what will happen? It will get teared off also. Okay. Sometimes some sleeves may be lost in case of shirts. Okay. During this tangling and entangling effect. So that should be properly taken care during the garment dyeing. Okay. This is one of the paddle machines, this describes a sock dyeing machine basically. So these machines are simple in construction and can be having a very good productivity also. You can see the paddle which is keep on rotating and circulating the dye stuff which is available. Sometimes even the dye stuff is drained out also, other chemicals also can be treated with this. But only thing is, it is as like an open bar and this paddle will be keep on rotating. Okay. These are also available at various shapes and various sizes depending upon the what kind of garments we are processing. You can see the paddling action where it will be pushing and raising, pushing and raising. Now you can see the operator who is bringing a tub so that these garments can be unloaded onto this and to carry. So all the socks which are completed with the treatment of dyeing and sometimes certain finishes also can be done, the entire machine head will get raised and then what happens? All the garments are loaded into this bin. Okay. It can be transferred very easily and then it can raised again, the dye particles and other the batch will be maintained and the new garments are loaded again inside this machine, the paddle dyeing machine. This is a horizontal padding paddle dyeing machine. So sometimes after conditioning and proper immersion will take place and whatever the chemicals which are required, this chemical dosing and then the dye dosing, everything will be done into this machine as like in the open bar state. Depending upon the temperature required and the time required, time and temperature, both are very important in this case, time and temperature. So afterwards, this will be taken out, the cycle will get repeated. In this video, we are going to see a oval paddle dyeing machine. This machine, as the name describes, which is in the oval shape, and these are also computerized and programmable logic controllers will drive various functions of these machines. You can see the dyed garments which are floating around the liquor which is there in this dyeing machine, and the paddle is pushing both the dye particles and the garments. Once the dyeing is over and washing also is over, these will be carried forward to a hydro extractor where it will rotate at a very high speed and removes all the moisture which is there within the garments and which will let the drying very easily and energy efficiently. This is the structure and the working of the oval paddle dyeing machine. We will see the video again. So these are PLC controlled machines and you can see the paddle which is pushing the garments by means of these rotations. So this is the blades of the paddle wheels. Earlier as we discussed, the shape of the paddle wheel, the edges of the paddle wheel should be rounded off so that it will be very easy and it will not create abrasion on top of the garments. So that is the paddle dyeing machine in case of a oval shaped one. So this is the hydro extractor. This is a rotary drum dyeing machine. First one is the paddle dyeing machine. The other category is the rotary drum dyeing machine. In this rotary drum type, there are basically two types. The rotating drum type and another one is tumble drying machine, tumble dyeing machine. Okay. So in this, the movement of the textile materials that may be a small garments or bigger garments and all will take place and the liquor will be stationary. Okay. So this is the entire is the drum. The bottom part up to 40% will be consisting of the liquor and which will be having a perforations on the sections. Okay. So as it will be keep on rotating, as the one segment will come into the contact, then the liquor will get penetrated and it will be raised. So it will be as a continuous immersion raising, immersion raising, immersion raising. This process will be repeated in case of the rotary drum dyeing machine. So this machine consisting of perforated cylinder drum. The complete drum will be having perforations on the surface and which rotates slowly inside a vessel of slightly bigger in size. Say one is 1.2 meter in diameter and the inside diameter will be 1 meter. Okay. So the internal drum is divided into number of compartments to ensure the rotation of the goods with the drum rotation. If it is a simple one, then what will happen? All the material will be rotated at a single position only. So the action of immersion and raising will not happen. So what happens? This drum is located into 4 compartments or 6 compartments or 8 compartments depending upon the diameter of the drum. Okay. So that what will happen? The immersion and raising action will be completed in this one. Then the outer vessel holds the required quantity of dye liquor and even the temperature or heat adjustments and all other things also can be given. So next to this one will be a stock tank. Okay. So whereas all the dyes and other chemicals can be kept and the program can be written to a programmable logic controller, PLC based systems, such that after 20 minutes the dye particles need to be given. And after 10 minutes, NaCl to be added. After 10 minutes, the remaining part of the dye also need to be given or something like that. The design or the dyeing pattern will vary between the type of goods and what kind of dye is being used and various other parameters. Okay. Yeah. So, in this, since it is a closed condition and all, easily it can be raised up to 140 degrees centigrade. Okay. So, what happens? This machine, it will be consisting several apartments, several compartments. Okay, that may be made into either 4 segments or 6 segments or 8 segments or sometimes even more than that also depending upon the drum diameter. Okay, within the drum, it consists of 2 drums. One is external drum and one is internal drum. The internal drum consists of perforations on the surface so that the dye particle can be easily penetrated to inside. Okay, holes means not as like very small holes, as like maybe 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch. Okay, that means 1 centimeter to 2 centimeter. 1 centimeter to 2 centimeter holes will be there so that the dye liquor can be easily penetrated into the garment. And the garments loading will be done into each compartment so that the lowering, immersion and raising action can be done as it is keep on rotating. So we have kept in one compartment, as it is being rotated, then immersion will take place since this half of the rotation. Then again, the raising action will take place. So that immersion and raising will take place and it will give a very good dyeing effect. Okay, and the outer vessel, this consists of the dye liquor, so that, and next to this one is the stock tank, where the dye particle and other chemicals which are required and all will be kept in this. Okay, so as this is closed enclosure and this is enclosed machine and all, it can be reached up to 140 degrees centigrade very easily. Okay, this is a rotary drum dyeing machine. We will see a video later. Okay. So, compared with parallel dyeing machines, these machines consist of lower liquor ratio. That is one of the very important point why the rotary dyeing machines are much popular. Okay. So, these are environmentally friendly because of this lower liquor ratios. The MLFs are comparatively very less, we could say around up to like 15 to 25 15:1 to 25:1, depending upon the garment and various other things like that. And the movement is gentle. Why? Because within the compartment itself, it will be there. So it will not be keep on revolving into the entire liquor and that. So the movement is gentle, and frequent operation of squeezing and immersing can be done. Immersing and raising. And as it is an enclosed machine, the rapid heating and cooling is possible. So rapidly the required temperature can be raised, and very fastly it can be reduced also. And the centrifugal extraction also is possible within this machine. Whereas in the paddle machines and all, what happens? It need to be kept in a centrifugal action in a separate machine to remove the excess moisture. Okay, that is also one of the very good point. What is that? Centrifugal extraction. Also called as hydro extraction. Hydro extraction is nothing but removing of excess or full of moisture. In case in normal cloths and all, it will be just bent and remove the water, right? In a similar fashion, as it can be rotated at a very faster speed in case of hydro extraction mode. So what happens, all the excess moisture can be easily removed from this drum type dyeing machine. Okay. And the drum speed can be variable. Okay, it can rotate even 10 rpm or even it can rotate at 200 rpm. Okay, so variable drum speeds is possible, and then reverse direction is also possible. Nowadays, if you can see any of the washing machines at home also, sometimes what it will do, sometimes it will rotate in the clockwise and then it will rotate in the anti-clockwise. Why? Basically, for the better penetration of the chemical into the textile substrate. Similarly, same fashion, it also can be currently or concurrently, means either in either of the direction of this drum can be modified very easily, or we can put a system in such a way that 30 seconds in clockwise, 30 seconds in anti-clockwise. Okay. Then the continuous circulation of goods. The goods are keep on rotating. Okay, these are getting immersed and then raised. So it improves the migration control, that means the entanglement and all which generally takes place, that can be reduced. And in many cases, the variable water levels with overflow rinsing capabilities. Means water levels also can be maintained. Sometimes what happens, if it is more and all also, it can be automatically remove the moisture also. Okay, chemical dosing is there, the capacity is increased. Then what happens? It will automatically drain some of the content. Understood? Yeah. Then the large diameter feed and discharge lines, so that it minimizes the filling and draining time. Okay. So the stock tanks are next to it. Okay. As you can see in the figure, the stock tanks, different stock tanks. Okay. Few will be for the last one, and the bigger one is for the dye, and other are for the chemicals and that. Then obviously, as it is a microprocessor control, only loading, and you put the pattern into the machine and it will be keep on completing the cycle, as like a domestic washing machine. Once you load it, you put the detergent, then what will happen? Nowadays many technologies are there in many areas. Like if you understand, you can put a hot line, hot water line, or bubble technology, foam technology, so many things which came into the picture. Similarly, all the technologies can be implemented in case of a drum type dyeing machine. Okay. So, the general parameters and features of this rotary machine is, so which minimizes the tangling. Okay, the entanglement effect can be very much reduced and simple to operate, and size also is comparatively very small, as many compartments are there. Even though the same volume occupancy of a paddle machine and a drum machine is there, the drum machine will consist of more occupancy, as because of more compartments. So each compartment can be of different types of garments also. and the cost of the machine is also not very high. I'm not very sure how much per tonnage capacity and all will be there, but comparatively it is not in crores and all. Okay, depending upon the this thing and all, it is comparatively easy. And if some people are interested in terms of the entrepreneurship and all, they can consider a garment dyeing plant also. Okay, then the drum dyeing centrifuging machines are also called as multi-purpose drum machines. Okay, so it can be used even for a softener wash also. Okay, whereas you do not want to dye the goods. Okay, but only for the softener wash also it can be used. Okay, since the machine, the technology is there, it can be used for multi-purpose. Okay, instead of dyeing, it can be used only for the softener wash also. Or multi-rapid drying and centrifuging machines. These are also called as multi-rapid dyeing centrifuging machines. Means very fastly it can dye, and also it can also remove the excess moisture, the hydro extraction would take place. That's why these names came into picture. Since these machines can perform scouring, dyeing, centrifuging and the conditioning like softener wash and other things also successively, means all the, these operations can be completed within one machine. Isn't it good? Isn't it time saving? Yes. But sometimes what happens is the scouring and all will be maybe done before the garment construction itself. But if it requires, these operations also can be done in these machines. What is this? A rotary drum type dyeing machine. So you can see here the drum consisting of four segments. Okay, whereas it is quite big, the drum size is around 1.5 meters. So this is a PLC controlled and computerized machine, so that we can loading of the machines and all can be done. These are also available at a very small capacity, it's like 2 kg capacity also. So in this, you can see the drum which is rotating and which is circulating the liquor or the chemical which is there. That is the first version where before closing it. Okay. So basically this machine what you are seeing is like a tumble dyeing machine. The small capacity which is there. But again, it can be of a big capacity also. Tumble dyeing machine. Okay. In case of drum dyeing machine, so what is the difference between the tumble dyeing machine and the drum dyeing machine? This is a tumble dyeing machine. Okay. Whereas inside will be closing, the operator is loading the garments inside. Okay. So whatever the required garments, all the garments can be kept. So it can be used not only for dyeing, it may be scouring or sometimes bleaching, dyeing, or application of certain chemicals also can be done by using these machines. So you can see as it is keep on rotating, what happens is the dye liquor or the chemical which is there, which will be keep on moving. Okay. So far it is rotated in one direction, now it changed its direction to the other side. Okay, and the tumble dyeing machine does not have any compartments. The tumble dyeing machine does not have any compartments. Okay, the inside the drum, you can see the perforated structure which is inside. That may be either three compartments which are completely closed, or it may consist a small segments, or very small segments, or very big segments also. Various types are available. You can see the segment which is available in this case. Okay. So, the dosage of chemicals and other things can be done very easily in case of a tumble dyeing machine. Okay. So, now this is the dosage of chemicals, whereas the dyeing chemicals and other chemicals or the dye particles can be loaded. So based on the program which is given to it, the loading will be keep on taking place. Okay. As we discussed, it can be used for multiple purposes. Okay. Maybe for scouring or maybe for bleaching or even for the dyeing can be done. Okay. So now this is a drum type of dyeing machine. So far we have seen the tumble dyeing machine and this is a rotary drum machine. In this, the drum is perforated and the loading of the garments by opening the drum will take place. Whereas in the tumble dyeing machine, what happens? In the perpendicular direction, the opening and closing will be there. Whereas inside itself, we will directly put it. This is the drum dyeing machine. Okay, in this you can see how the operator is loading. So, this will consist of only one door. So, by slightly inching the machine, what happens, the different compartments can be filled. So, once the process is done and all, so what happens ki by opening the door and other things, what we can do, we can open the and remove all the garments which are there inside. So, each compartment wise, it need to be removed. Or sometimes, there may not be any compartment also. But most generally, four compartments will be there, such that it is easy for the operators. Okay. Now again, he is closing the doors of this inside chamber, which is perforated in structure. You see. And the different segments, different kinds of garments also can be loaded. Okay. Or maybe out of 400 kg, each segment may be loaded with 100 kg, 100 kg and 100 kg. But we cannot have different shades in a single attempt. We can have only a single shade. But different types of garments can be kept in a different compartments. That is one of the advantages of the drum dyeing machine. So, compared with paddle dyeing machine, these drum dyeing machines are having various advantages. So, that is the reason if you consider only the garment dyeing as a part. So, either a tumble dyeing or a drum dyeing. But, the rotary drum type dyeing machines are only much possible in terms of the industry due to its advantages. As we discussed, the working principle of a rotary drum machine is such that what happens, the drum can be opened, and then inside the garments can be loaded. Okay, so it will be consisting, one is the outer drum and one is inner drum, both should be closed, and inner drum will be having a perforations on its surface, so that the outer drum will consist of the dielicker, it will be keep on penetrating, into the garments. Okay. So, the inner drums without dividing walls are provided with ribs. As we seen in the video, it can be either consisting of either ribs or compartments. Both are possible. As this is enclosed structure, the temperatures between 100 to 140 degrees centigrade can be easily achievable. Okay. This is suitable for knits as well as all other garments like sweaters and every other things also. The liquor circulation can be intensified using additional jets. Okay, by means of forcing the jets with the additional dielicker and all. And these drums can be rotated in both the directions as we discussed and also seen in the video. The drums can be rotated in both the directions. Okay, so this is the one we have seen in the video, the tumble dyeing machines. So these are the machines. Generally used for the small garments. Why? Because if there is no perforations inside, the tangling effect can be much higher. So, the design wise, the tumble dyeing machines are similar to commercial laundry machines, but only difference is that the temperature which can go and the ability to react with various types of aqueous solutions. That is the major difference. The principle of operation is load the material into the perforated inner SS tanks, stainless steel tanks. Why? Because it only will not get corrosion. Okay. Corrosion is one of the biggest problem in case of the machines. And all the machines should be having a thorough finish such that the corrosion will not be a big problem in this case. So, this inside tank will be fixed to the shaft and it will be keep on rotating as like a drum. This drum is divided into compartments sometimes for moving of the goods with rotation of the drum. And sometimes it may be provided into compartments, or sometimes it may be consist of ribs. Okay. So the tumble dyeing machines, a variety of tumble dyeing machines are having higher rotation speeds and can spin dry at the end of the cycle. Once it is done, what happens is this cycle, the drum will be rotated at a very high speed, such that the hydro entanglement, the hydro extraction also will be takes place within the machine. So that is one of the advantages of both drum dyeing machine and also tumble dyeing machines. Both are rotary drum type. Okay. So these are similar to the dry cleaning machines. The rotary drum machines are more efficient and cleaner to operate than a paddle machines. In the paddle machines, which are very intricate in design, and cleaning of the entire dye stuff is also much difficult. Okay. And large amount of liquor need to be wasted in terms of the paddle dyeing machines. But in case of a drum dyeing machine, this possibility will not be there. And more vigorous mechanical action often promotes more shrinkage and bulking, which may be desirable for some of the articles. Okay, if you want more agitated action, then we can increase the drum speed in such a way that it will create the fuzziness. Nowadays, in some of the movies also, as I understand, and in some of the winter collections, what will happen? The more fuzzy garments, okay, it will be consisting more hairiness on the surface, which are required. So, in order to produce that sort of effect, by rotating or the tumbling or at very higher speeds, what will happen? The agitated action will create such sort of fuzzy appearance, and it will create the desirable effects in case of some of the articles. So, in order to handle the higher quantities and large production of similar pieces, the latest machines are provided with automatic features and sophistications. Like once all the chemicals are stopped and only loading and unloading is the only process. You can combine with scouring, bleaching, dyeing, and any of the finish applications. All these applications can be completed within the drum dyeing machine. That may be either a rotary drum or tumble dyeing machine. Okay. So which is more advantageous, paddle or drum? If the garments are very small and repeated shades will be completely or very rarely, means if the manufacturing capacity will produce only four different types of shades, there are no other type of shades, as like sock machines, as like socks manufacturing units. In those cases, paddle machines are the best. In case of a shirts or trousers or any of the goods where the shades are frequently changing, in those cases, the rotary drum type machines are much more suitable. I hope you understood where we can use which sort of machines and what are the various advantages and disadvantages of these two major category of the machines. Then another one is like a toroid dyeing machine. Okay, so which is obsolete at this time. So it was developed in 1970s under, whereas the movement of the liquor is like as like a toroid. Okay, if you see in this animation, so what happens, the liquor, it is like a donut or a vada, as like vada. So what happens, the chamber is like this. So what happens, it will be keep on circulating inside, and then the movement is as like a toroid shape. So this is one of the novel approach for the garment dyeing, but it was considered as a novel approach, but it is not much being used. Only the commercial, the drum type dyeing machines are much used. Okay. And the company is also recently closed in 2015. So there are no such machines which are available for this toroid dyeing machines. So this modified peg toroid machines, as we discussed, which is obsolete, but it is one of the principle we need to understand. That's why we are discussing about this. So these machines are suitable for atmospheric pressure and also even for pressure drying. That is one of the major advantages. It can be worked with high temperature and high pressure. And full automation and hydro extraction is possible as the design is in circular in shape. And the speed performance is simplified to make the machine more versatile and free from operating problems. Irrespective of all the R&D and all, but still this machine is not being much successful due to various reasons. Okay, that may be marketing or any other issues, but these kind of machines are not available. So that is the end of this class, the garment dyeing machinery. Okay, I hope you all understood and the differences between the two type of machines, either the paddle dyeing machine or the drum dyeing machines. Sorry, the paddle dyeing machine and the rotating type of drum machines. If you see in this photograph, this is without covering, only the inner surface with perforations. Just for your understanding, I have kept this. So in this class, what we understood, there are different types of garment dyeing machines, and the conventional fabric dyeing machines are may not be useful for dyeing the garments. Okay, generally these are works with two principles. One is paddle dyeing machines, in that it can be subcategorized into either a square type or a horizontal paddle, and another one is a oval paddle, and the third one is the HT paddle. And in terms of rotating type, drum type, there are two types. One is tumbler dyeing machine, another one is rotary drum type machine. In case of a tumbler machine, what happens, the perforations will be there, of course, but what happens ki the perforated drum may be made into different compartments or only certain ribs will be there. Okay, these are much good for the smaller garments, whereas it can be done with various multiple processing like scouring, bleaching, dyeing, and also the softener finish or any of the finishing attachment also which can be given. Okay, and there are various other developments are also there, but this is the most commonly used machines everywhere in the world, the rotary drum type dyeing machines. Okay, of course, as we discussed in the garment dyeing, there are various processes. If the whole garment need to be dyed, then these garments will be helpful. In case if it is a tie and dye and all, then maybe we can use both paddle or this one, both. Okay, or even a open bath also may be sufficient. Okay, and in case of 3D printing and other things and all, there will be various technologies. Of course, we will be discussing about them in the further coming videos. I hope you learned something new today, and have a great day. Thank you. Thank you.